Howdy folks, and welcome back to Let's Play The Elder Scrolls 3 Morrowind. As per usual, we're just jumping on in here, and we have Yurt, and people wandering, and you guys should have heard the creepy sound effects that were playing before we actually started recording here. It was terrifying. Anyways, Wise Woman's Hut, let's do this. Let's see what we have in the Arabanimson here. This is Minara. She has a nice little crown.
May I help you?
Yes! I seek your counsel. I warn you, be wary of Ashkan Ulathpal and his supporters. They all hate outlanders and love nothing more than to kill them and loot them. They do not respect custom or hospitality, and they think nothing of killing unarmed men, women, or children. They are bad men and bad leaders, and you should fear them. Really? So it sounds like I'm going to murder them. Ulathpal is always in his yurt, protected by his bodyguard, Gulakanaz. I'm just a weak woman, and I'm sure you would know best, but I would kill Ahaz first, the weaker of the two. And if I had secret magics and powers, I would use them to preserve me while I defend against two enemies at once. Really? Really? Good to know. Also, my train of thought just exploded on itself. I don't know. I was gonna say something and then it just disappeared. Interesting. Okay, so we're gonna be going in here and fighting some people. I could do regeneration. This might be worthwhile. I mean, it's not the fastest healing in the world, but it's healing. That's, I guess, about it. I mean, we can ready our paralysis. Are you guys gonna just immediately attack me? No. Alright, so that's Ahaz right there. Well, we'll try talking. You're the outlander who claims to fulfill the Nerevarine prophecies. What do you want? I'm actually here about... Yeah, I'm an outlander, okay. I have nothing to say to you. I despise you and your kind. Go away. What if I persuade you? Eh? No. Alright, well, Eh? We know about the prophecies, we think they are foolish and superstitious. Don't bother us with this nonsense. So it seems like they are legit giving me no out here but to murder this dude. Alright. I'm down to fuck you guys up. Hey there. Sit still for a second. Like, kill your buddy. Perfect! Just long enough. Oh, there's a third one in here, playing the drums. Are you gonna be trouble? Are you trouble? Who's there? What? Oh, they've plucked out his eyes! I don't know. Our journal was updated. I've slain one of the war-loving Ashlanders, but perhaps it would have been impossible to have friendly dealings with them or their leaders anyways. What? All right. He had a war axe on him, a glass axe, so we're gonna take that. And there's my money back. That's why I tried it, because I knew if I was gonna get violent, then we'd be able to just take it back. Sinit heals Heart of Fire. Fortifies willpower. Like, that's okay, I guess. It's something that I would probably forget to use the grand majority of the time. That's okay. All right, so we've killed them. Let's go talk to the wise woman and see what she has to say here. They're dead. Okay, well, I killed two of them, but she didn't really have much to say. Oh, here we go. You should be named Arabanimson Nerevarine. Never, not while the Ashkan Ulathpal and his war-loving Arabanimson live. They all hate outlanders and are proud and haughty and will never suffer an outlander to rule them. You'd be Nerevar of the Arabanimson. You must kill Ulathpal and his supporters. The Gulkans, Ahaz, Renabi, and Ashu Ane. Ahehe, maybe? Then you must help me make peace-loving Arabanimson Gula Hanamura or Ashkan. Alright, Ashkan Hanamu. But then name you Arabanimson Nerevarine. Yeah, they've got all these weird names and they just throw them at you endlessly. It is so hard to read along. But before anything else must be done, you must first eliminate Ulathpal and his supporters. Then you should come speak to me and we will discuss further how you might be named Arabanimson Nerevarine. Okay, so which two did I kill? I gotta get names here. We killed Ulathpal and Ahaz. All right, so that's two of them. Hey, war-loving ones. All right, Under the previous Ashkan, Han Amu's father, Arya Amu, the Arab and Imsen, grew bold and arrogant, confident in their strength of arms. Now Ashkan, who left Paul and his champions, has become cruel and violent, and our people live in fear. I am of the peace-loving Arab and Imsen, and I wish that Aaron Amu's son, Han Amu, might become our new Ashkan, but we are weak, and Han Amu could never challenge Ulath Paul, let alone all his supporters. Alright, well, who are all his supporters? Well, here, tell me about Han Amu. Han Amu is the son of former chief Arian Amu, but he is nothing like his father. His birth gave him strong claim to lead the tribe, but of the many virtues required by an Ashkan, he lacks only three things: strength, courage, and wisdom. So he lacks everything. Alright. Asu Ahe. Asu Ahe is a great fighter, the most strong and experienced of the Arab and Imsen. He wears enchanted armor and boasts that none of the Arab and Imsen can defeat him, not even Ulath Paul. So we have to kill him too then, huh? Let's see, I must kill Ulath Paul and his supporters, the Gulakans, Ahaz, Renabe, and Asu Ahe. Alright. So we've killed Ahaz, so we have Renabi and Asu Ahe. So let's go find them.
Go ahead, Outlander.
That's not you. Alright, so there's Han Amu's yurt. Alright, there's Asu Ahe, and there's, alright, so here's Renabi. Oh, you're a wizard, are you? Well, I'm kind of a wizard too. Let me show you. Oh no, he resisted it. His spell immunity shield saved him. Sadly, he did not have a sword immunity shield. Cheap restore health potions, sure. Ember hand, bitter hand. All right, so he's got some weakness inducing stuff and gauntlets. Interesting. What, can you wear gloves under gauntlets? That would be news to me. Some chitin spears there. All right, Asu Ahe, with your magicked up armor. Are you immune to magic?
Yes.
Yes. Yeah, I love it. He even answered. How convenient. Let's do this. Your armor is powerful, but my skill at the blade is unmatched. There's only one other in this entire region that's as good with swords as I am. And it ain't you. Where's magic armor, huh? Mountain Spirit, worth 3,600 and gives shield 10 points for a constant effect. That's actually probably pretty good armor. We're gonna take, this is actually 107, 88, all right. I was gonna say, if we were skilled, I think this is medium armor, I wanna say. Yeah, if we were skilled in medium armor, I would bet that this would probably be contender for some of the best armor in the game because it has that shield on it. Because if I recall correctly, shield just gives you a flat, like, shield 10 gives you just 10 points of armor. So that's pretty potent. However, we are now overweight. What am I going to drop? Probably some of these jewels and stuff. Well, this raw ebony for one. I don't even know where I picked that up. I don't think we need the brown book anymore. And Yingling's Ledger. I think we want to keep this. I seem to recall this being mentioned that's used for one of the Fighter's Guild quests. I just take his gold. He didn't need it anymore. Well, that problem was solved. So, all right, we're gonna go talk to her. I thought that was a coin on the ground. We're gonna talk to her and see what's up here. Hey, I killed your buddy. Council. Now with Ashkan, Ulath, Paul, and his supporters dead, we may consider the Nerevarine prophecies and how you might be named Arab and Imsen Nerevarine. With Ulath, Paul, and his supporters out of the way, it's a simple matter to be named Nerevarine of the Arab and Imsen. All you need to do is persuade Gulakan, Han Amu, to become the Ashkan of the Arab and Imsen. Seek him out in the Gulak Yurt. Be prepared, however, he is not the material one would choose when looking to make an Ashkan. He may be difficult to persuade. That's okay. Enough money and weapons will make anybody a little bit ballsier than they normally are. Hey there, buddy. Not you. You. Wow, you.
Is there something I can do for you?
In stereo. Let's see, no matter what Maneri says, I'm not interested and I don't want to become the Ashkan. Why? Yes, I recognize it. Ahaz wore that amulet, Senit Keel's Heart of Fire. Ahaz had it from his father, and Ahaz's father had it from Kenitu Nila, and Kenitu Nila had it from Senit Keel, a great witch warrior. But what has that to do with me wanting to be an Ashkan? We'll give him the amulet and make a little speech. Thank you. Your lesson is clear. It is the amulet that gives courage in battle, and it is the idea of the amulet that gives confidence to the tribe. But it is the Ashkan who wears the amulet, the Ashkan who accepts responsibility for the safety of the tribe, who holds the fate of the tribe in his hands. It's a sobering lesson, and I must give it thought. Alright. What does our journal say? I believe he has taken the lesson to heart and will consider accepting his responsibilities as Ashkan and considering naming me Nerevarine. Nice. So hey, you wanna be Ashkan? Well, oh. So we have multiple things to give to him. Okay, I recognize it. It is the war axe of my father, the war axe of Arian Amu. Ulaf Paul had it from my father and carried it as Ashkan, but that was, what does that to do with my wanting to be an Ashkan? We'll give it to him and make a little speech. Thank you, your lesson is clear. It is the axe that gives strength in war, and it is the idea of the axe that gives confidence in the tribe, but it is the Ashkan who bears the axe, who accepts the responsibility for the safety of the tribe, who holds the fate of the tribe in his hands. It's a sobering lesson, and I must give it thought. Okay. I don't want to be Ashkan. I'm not good at fighting, and no one likes me. I can't make anyone do anything. Why won't anyone just leave me alone? You wuss! Is there a third thing, maybe, that I missed that I have to give him? Because, let's see, we got... I don't think we took anything from this guy. Maybe we need to take these? Or it might be Racer Beak here. We'll go try. Hey. Hey, no. He's just being a wuss. Hey! Here's 1,000 gold. Stop being a wuss. Please, I don't want to be Ashkan. Don't you understand? I won't be any good at it. I'm going to be a complete failure and everyone will hate me even more. God almighty, you are a whiner. I'm gonna keep pestering you. Can we just like spam it on him until he's like, fine? No. I want you to be the Ashkan, you little shit. What Minari says. What does she say? I don't care what she says, I don't want to be Ashkan. Jeff just... No. Okay. I was just seeing that if I talked to him, like, again and, like, exited the conversation, if it would just, like, slowly erode him to the point that he would accept it. Alright, so yeah, he's being a wuss. Give him strength, willpower, and intelligence. So we have given him probably strength and willpower. More tokens recognized by all the tribe. All right, here we go. So we, yeah, there's probably something else on one of these guys that I missed. Is there something I can do for you? It's probably, I just noticed that this gauntlet, where is it? This thing gives 10 shield as well. Nope. But I mean, like, look at that. That gets us to 100, and this gets us to 107, and the difference in defense between those, like, the gauntlet is 220 armor rating, and this thing is 3 plus 10. So that goes to show you just how powerful just having a shield enchantment on your stuff is. It makes a huge difference. You don't have anything else. Did I miss looting one of you jerks? Ah, the Wind of Ahaz, maybe. I'm encumbered! Racer Beak, get out of my inventory. You're not necessary. Hey, I got you another thing. Ah! Okay, so it's not the Wind of Ahaz. Do you have something I need? Well, if you can't see me, can I just... Alright, you have nothing. Seriously, dude? I'm not even gonna dignify you with a violent response. No. I probably have like a wanted level now, don't I? No. All right, cool. Man, I don't know. All right, so we gave him the Heart of Fire, which is, yeah, courage and strength. So yeah, he needs something for intelligence.
Yes.
This must have Rapal.
What do you want?
Do either of you guys have anything? You'll find no welcome here, I'm afraid. Guys, I need something for intelligence. I'd figure that the mage would have that, but I really don't see anything unless he's got it stashed in here somewhere, which I suppose he could. But I'm not seeing anything. Let's get my cat's eye going so I can see a little bit better in case it's like hidden under a table or something. Because that's something that I could see these guys doing. He's back to drumming. Combat music's playing. He doesn't like me being in here, but he's back to drumming. All right, so there's Razorbeak. And I'm gonna go talk to the wise woman and see if she maybe has any suggestions to me. Hey there, let's see here. Tell me about Hanamu. All right, so yeah, we need something to give him wisdom. Let's see, I've defeated the war-loving Erebonimson and the peace-loving Erebonimson rule our tribe, but now we have no Ashkan, and I fear we will suffer the attacks of outcast Ashlanders. You must persuade him to become our Ashkan. Tokens? By tokens, I mean well-known tribal heirlooms. Here we go. Objects of power handed down through the generations by Gulakans and Ashkans. Such tokens are marks of power and distinction and might give him the abilities and confidence he needs. Yeah, but like, what are the tokens, man? Help me out here. Do you have one? Like, are you gonna sell it to me? Is that why you can barter? No, you just have a bunch of like random crap that I don't care about. This is something that it doesn't seem like it should be as hard as it is here. But I don't know. Lady. Is it, it's probably this crown she's got. Like, I don't know. I don't know. Let's see. All right, they're out of the way. All right, he's a wuss. All right, I can only ever ask her about the one thing there. Tokens. Tokens, it's all the same. She's a traitor.
Is there something? Yes, Outlander.
Like I said, it seems sensible to me that it would be on the mage. But I've already taken all his stuff. I don't know, guys. I love it, I come in here and the combat music starts playing. It's great. What about you? Who are you? You are the Outlander who claims to be the Nerevarine. You'll find no welcome here, I'm afraid. Traitor, our traitor, Mouser Rapal has his yurt within the Ashkans and the Gulakans' yurts. Alright, so Mouser Rapal is the traitor. So let's see. If he has anything. Not really, no. You have anything that would give somebody wisdom by any chance there, buddy? No? No. You do, however, repair things. And yeah, like all of our stuff needs repaired. It's been a long time since we've done any of this, so I figure we might as well get all of our stuff Like in tip-top shape. And who are you? You are all right. So none of these people are really, they're not hostile, but they're certainly not friendly towards me. But they're not giving me any help. So I think I'm actually, well, we're at 20 minutes. So I'm gonna go ahead and call it here and you folks can chime in and let me know what I'm missing here. I'm sure it's something blatantly obvious, but as per usual, I would appreciate the help. So thank you ahead of time for that. And I will catch you all next time when the adventure continues. And I think we're going to be confirmed as the Nerevarine. Fun times. Until then.